All right, I'm at the Petersen Automotive Museum, and they're celebrating the 50th anniversary of the Mustang this weekend. I'm not sure how long the display is going to be up for, but I wanted to walk you through the entire display so you can get an idea what they've got set up here. They've got a 65 convertible right when you walk in. And then each one of these, this used to be Ronald Reagan, as it says. So they've got one of each of the iconic cars. So I'll kind of walk you through, take a look. So this used to be Reagan's 65 convertible. And if you pan through here, we've got a little display of Mustang 1 Concept 1, which we just shot over at the 50th in Las Vegas, which is kind of neat. A couple of collectibles. High style meets authentic performance. So here's the original design sketch. And there it is, 62 V4 powered Mustang 1. It's pretty nice to have this huge wall display here. Pretty cool. They got a 429 Ram Air car in front, 71 Mach 1. In white, and then this is next to a little Mustang too, also a white car. So these are all to be private owners. I'm not sure how many of these would be owned by the actual Petersen. So this is the probably privately owned right here, and they're just on display. So. And here's a Cobra, 93 Cobra. Very clean. So it's neat, they have a little above each one. So this says third gen right there, and it says 79 and 93, the Fox body. And they've chosen to put the Cobra in here as the representative of the Fox body. Which is nice. And they got a Cobra R right here. It's 2000 Cobra R. And this car right here has the front splitter on it, so you can see. And then they've got the new Edge. The SN95 still on a Fox platform underneath, but they changed the moniker to SN95. But and then here is the GTH, which is the Hearst rental car. This is a fastback design, or the trunk design, not a convertible. So it's the hard top. And you can see they've got it up here, fifth generation. They call it the modern Mustang, which will now be replaced by the sixth gen. And then coming this direction, they've got a photo up. I'm not sure if it looks like there's a space here for the new car, which they'll probably have. I don't know, maybe they will or won't have it this weekend. I know they at some point they're going to stick one up here. I just got a lot of people taking photos. I'm trying to find a move. It's an old drag car right here. Ohio George, the Malco Gasser. Drag racing history in here. I'm not sure if this is part of the Gas collection, Galpin Autosports, and they've got a vintage drag tree in here, which is pretty cool. This I do know is part of the Galpin Ford collection. They built it. This is that 69 Mustang Mach 4. It's a 4-engine crazy motor in it. Four motors in it. I think they're all Windsor based, but I can't remember if I read they were 351 motors. But I know that Galpin still owns, it's part of their museum collection. They have their own museum. So they brought this down for the show, for the weekend. Really neat. They're the ones that built it too. It's so cool they still have it. Kind of walk around this side. Still got Galpin Ford right on there. So this one's a Bonneville. It says Bonneville Racer on this one. I'm not sure if it's a salt flat car. I guess it is. They got a big batch up with the salt flat. So this is a Bonneville salt flat race car. And they've got the Mach 1 stripe on it off of 69 style. Let's take a quick peek. So it's 2008 Mustang 500C Bonneville Racer. Oh, Danny Thompson. So that's the Mickey Thompson son. Actually got this thing up to 252 miles an hour. Pretty cool. This is a retractable hardtop. I guess this was a design study. This was done by Galpin. Galpin's been doing customizing for a long time. In fact, they're credited for bringing back the Mustang convertible in 83. The Bachman family has owned it for so long, and I guess they decided to build a retractable or a convertible in 82, and Ford came out and supposedly looked at it, and 83 the Fox body became a convertible again, and it's been in continuous production, the convertible for the Mustang, ever since. So you can credit Galpin for that. It's pretty cool. So, and kind of in the main area here, you've got, this is that Iacocca car, also part of the Galpin Autosports collection. I think they built 100 of these, maybe, I don't know. Something like that. Kind of built this fastback style into it. You can see it kind of have a hatch instead of a trunk. So, you can see the eye on the... steering wheel. Here's one of the Celine Carnelli Jones tribute cars. They couldn't call it a Boss 302 at the time. Ford owned the name and the rights, so this is pre-reissue of the Boss 302. That's the Carnelli Jones Special Edition, Limited Edition. And then they did the Fulmer last year, I think. Yeah, and this is next to this, this was sold new at Galpin Ford, and then I think Bo Bachman bought it back at Barrett Jackson for $300,000 is what I read.
Is that right?
So, it's a barn find. They've kept all the original paint on it. It still has the original Kragers on it. They didn't restore it. It's just been completely rubbed out, and it's in their private collection at Gas in their private, you know, area. It's pretty neat.
Joaquin, look at me, pues, don't move, please.
Joaquin,
look at me.
And there's 68 GT500KR. In Acapulco blue, it's beautiful. So first year of the 428 Cobra Jet in the Mustang 68, and the prior to that they were police interceptors, and after that they were Cobra Jets. So this one here is an automatic, very nice. And then next to that is a GT 500, 428 Cobra Jet 69. Actually, it's a 70. You can see the stripes on there. So the 69s that they did not sell became 1970 Shelbys. They just re-vinned them. And Ford had to get special permission from in the federal government to re-vin them. And if you've ever looked at a 70 Shelby, you'll notice that the key, well, I can't tell you in this one, it's other previous videos, but in 70 and up, all the keys were moved to the column. And in 69, they were still on the dash. So this, all the 70s still have them on the dash because they were... Right, here's the last couple of cars that are in this main section. There's a 68 GT CS California Special. This one's kind of in a Highland green, it looks like. Has a standard green interior. This one's a stick shift. Looks like it might be a four-speed. It is a four-speed. This one's beautifully restored. And then next to that, there's a Boss 302 70. Looks like it's medium gold metallic. Hope you enjoyed it, and I will take you over to a couple other spots, show you the rest of the display.